Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brett Kingman, and as I'm going to say it again, you are in my little studio on Mount Eliza, Victoria, Australia, and thank you for joining me today. Boss have sent me the brand new Generation 3 Katana 50, which is kind of the entry model in the Katana series. There's five new models. Did you know that the Katana has been around now for about 6 years and they've sold like 500,000 units? That's a lot of Katana's amps out there. So there must be something in it, huh? They're good value, they've got all the right sounds, and now they've got even more sounds. So what's new with the Katana Generation 3? Well, for starters, we've got headphone outputs. That's a good thing. USB-C outputs, which is really quick and really easy to use. In fact, I'm using USB-C to record directly to my Logic DAW this afternoon in the Mac. I can fly the flag for USB-C connectivity. It's very good. This is a Fender Vintera 2. It's got some JJ's, we call them Fat Tony's pickups in it, which are basically a Telecaster pickup and a couple of high-quality Strat pickups. Now, one of the great things about the Katana Generation 3, one of the new things that has to be pushed is the new pushed amp model. And let's have a look at it. You'll find it in between crunch and clean up here on the editor. I've brought up the editor so we get a nice view, but of course you can dial it up on the amp too if you want to. So what's the pushed amp all about? Well, there are two variations like there are with the other amps. And if we back gain off to about noon, and we back volume off to about here, it's going to sound like this. So it's kind of an old school, almost a Tweedy, Fenderish sort of an amp. Just back that reverb right off for a moment, and I'll bring the contour back to neutral. So it's got the it sounds like a little tweed combo to me, but when you hit the variation button, it's conjuring up old Voxish sorts of tones. Of course, the harder you push the gain, the more, you know, crunch you're going to get out of it. So I've written a couple of presets with the new pushed amp, and I've actually loaded a few into the Librarian here, which we can just slot in anytime we want. The Librarian's a great, very handy little utility in the desktop editor, and if I just, for instance, want to chuck it in here into number 2, I can do that. So now I can go back here to my editor. As usual, we've got, you know, a big selection of effects and things with which to garnish our amp tone with. So I've got a booster here. The clean booster's on, but, you know, it doesn't have to be the clean boost. It could be the mid boost if I want it. Over here in effects world, I've got a bit of a tremolo happening. There's a delay, which I don't have switched on, but I could. And reverb and EQs and all the other stuff that you would have found on the previous versions of the Katana. One great thing that we've got, in fact, I'll just switch that reverb off for a moment. Leave the little booster on. But over here in system, you will find all of the usual pages, including, you know, if you've got a foot control, GFC settings and all that sort of stuff, MIDI settings, USB settings, power control, global EQ, power amp settings, and the top one, line settings, which you can customize in your recorded mode, which is what we're listening to at the moment. I'll switch it on. and I can move my microphone. And change the distance. Of course, I can swap the type of mic as well, so I might want a 57. But I can also add a little bit of ambience. Which is just going to help, you know, give a little bit more natural kind of acoustic quality to whatever we're recording or even playing, especially if it's feeding front of house. So that's kind of cool, and you can have, you know, one or two different versions. And recall those whenever you want. There's a few presets here that I've already got in the librarian that I showed you earlier. Six, in fact, which I will upload and let Boss/Roland disseminate for your fun pleasure. I've written another one here called Clean Swim, which again is based on the push amp. I've got my volume up here just to drive the USB hard enough for the DAW. Over in reverb world, we're using the modulated reverb and quite a lot of it too. I don't mind a bit of delay. You can actually use it as a sort of instrument. And then over in delay world, I've got the panning delay. So if you're any good with the pinky swells on the Strat. You can do that sort of stuff. Crunch-o-push. So again, we've got the pushed amp, excuse me, a bit of single coil noise there. I can use the noise gate actually if I wanted to. Let's do that. There you go, all gone, just about. Don't want to take it all away. So I've got a booster here. It's the warm overdrive. Doing a very good job too. Now if I turn the variation switch on, it's a smoother sort of sound. It's a pretty good variation actually. So they're actually adding, you know, two completely different amps as far as I'm concerned into the firmware. Push the tone up a little bit on our booster. So the pushed amp is occupying that territory that wasn't really represented earlier in the earlier Katana models, and that is that vintagey, just going into breakup, tweedy, voxy kind of sound. We'll be right back. again, there are five different models of the Generation 3. There's the 50, which is what this little fella here is. Nice and light, single speaker. You've got the USB out. And as you get further up into the range with the 50EX and the 100 and the head and then the Artist, which has all of the features. In fact, I'll put the little comparison chart on the screen so you can have a look. You get more. For my purposes, I would probably be able to get away with the little Katana 50 as is, because it's small, it's got all the sounds in there, and we've got the great desktop editor. Now, the other thing that they've added is the BT Dual facility, which is almost like a 9-volt battery sized compartment that you can pop the little Bluetooth receiver into, and then if you have that, and I don't unfortunately, you can control it remotely with your iOS or some sort of remote app. And the desktop editor, the iOS editor is pretty much the same as the desktop editor that you're looking at now. That pushed amp, I'm going to take you out again with a bit of a jam if you're looking to further the facility of your Katana 2 or even the first Katana. Go out and have a listen to the Generation 3. Thank you for watching. See you soon.